you like to amaze your friends with science and magic this Halloween by creating a spooky dancing ghost? I'm going to show you how to do that. And for this experiment, you only need a few basic materials that you probably have around the house. You're going to need a balloon. You're going to need some tissue paper, a marker, some scissors, and some tape. So first thing you're going to do is you're going to cut out of the tissue paper, you're going to cut out the shape of a little ghost like this. First, I want to explain the tissue paper. If you've noticed, tissue paper has lots of individual layers in here. So for this experiment, you want the ghost to be as thin as possible. So try to peel off just one single sheet of the tissue paper. And then you're going to either draw your little ghost on here, however you want to do it, or free cut it, any shape you want. And you're going to cut it out of your tissue paper. Then you're going to take your ghost, and with the marker, you're going to decorate. You're going to give him or her two little eyes, a smile, however you want your ghost to look, to personalize them. And then you're going to take the tape, and take a little bit of tape, and just on the very bottom of your ghost, you're going to tape it to the table. So now we're going to take our balloon, we're going to blow it up. It off. And if you have trouble with this, you might need to get an adult to help you. So we're going to tie off our balloon. Now the fun part is we're going to rub this on our hair. And when we do this, there's invisible electrons with negative charges that are building up and they're attaching themselves to the balloon. And when we bring the balloon down to our ghost, he dances. Why did this happen? Because the electrons, the negative electrons on the balloon, had the power to pull the ghost's positive electrons up. It's an example of static electricity, which is really just an attraction of two opposite electrical charges. So it can be a sudden attraction, like when you're walking across the carpet and you touch your friend or something metal and you get a shock. Or it can be simply two socks when you pull them out of the dryer and they're stuck together. And when you peel them apart, you can kind of hear the crackle of electricity. So you could further this experiment by trying different things. You could try to use several layers of the tissue paper and see if the ghost will still dance. You could try to not tape your ghost down and try the experiment and see if the ghost will literally come up and stick to your balloon. Or you could try it with a different substance, like make the ghost out of fabric or cardboard or maybe aluminum foil and see if there is an attraction. You might find that some things actually repel and push away from the balloon. So I hope you'll enjoy making your own dancing ghost for Halloween.